Whether you call a bus, a van, the back of your car, or a tent home, staying cool and comfortable in the summer and warm in the winter are two vital components of a successful off-grid life. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some of my favorite ways to keep cool or stay warm, talk about how we can figure out how much power they need, and then get into whether or not this Anker PowerHouse 767 can power them to meet your needs, or maybe you need to just add an expansion battery to make it all come together. Before we go too far into this, let's talk about power. What is it, and how can we figure out how much we're using? Well, virtually every appliance out there has a label that looks a lot like this one on my favorite Makita router. Here it lists the operating voltage and the operating amperage. The same is true on this DC water pump. Now, what we do with that information is simply multiply the voltage times the amps, and that gives us the running wattage. No matter what voltage the appliance operates at or how many amps it draws, we'll always know how many watts it uses. Now let's talk about the wattage requirements of some of my favorite heating and cooling options for off-grid living, starting with the classic rooftop vent. These are awesome because they don't use lots of power, but they give you the feeling of a drastic temperature change. Most rooftop vents pull between 30 and 60 watts when they're in operation. My next favorite method for keeping cool on a hot summer day is gonna be a window-mounted AC unit. They're cheap, they're easy to install, and a lot of them have very low power consumption. My favorite options for a small bus pull under 500 watts apiece. Now, if you need something bigger, it goes all the way up to 1,000 or more, but those are a great option if you wanna go for powered cooling. If you wanna be a little more fancy, or maybe your rig already came with a unit, chances are you're familiar with a rooftop air conditioner. These are the most powerful options out there, but they use the most power. We're talking 1,200 to 1,500 watts of cooling electricity. My last and most favorite option has to be the mini split system. They're the most efficient in terms of wattage in for BTUs of cooling power out. And one of those units will typically pull between 900 and 1,000 watts, but deliver enough cooling to keep even a large rig comfortable. No matter what cooling option you use, it's important to understand their wattage requirements. And with that in mind, let's take a look at some of the popular ways that people choose to stay warm in their rigs. Now, the easiest way to keep warm is to simply plug in a space heater, but as you can imagine, that uses the most power. A typical space heater is going to consume between 1,500 and 1,800 watts running on high. If you're not going to be using the electricity to generate the heat directly, how can we use power to stay warm? Well, the trick is we've got to burn something. So in many cases, we'll use propane or diesel, we'll burn it, and then we'll use a fan powered by electricity to distribute that hot air throughout the rig. This could be a diesel heater, or it could be a propane furnace. You probably have one of those in your rig. These things are awesome because instead of 1800 watts or 1500 watts, we're only using about 30 watts to simply power the fan. This is a great option, and you can guess what my pick is if you're gonna be trying to stay warm off-grid. Now that we know about all of these different heating and cooling options, let's talk about how we can use that information to determine if the Anker PowerHouse can run them. Because we know the running watts of these devices, the first step is to make sure that the inverter, which is the output section of this, can handle it. The Anker PowerHouse 767 is capable of up to 2,400 continuous watts of output power, which we know is more than enough to run even a space heater or a rooftop air conditioner. Since we know that this has the output power to meet the demands of running it, the next thing to figure out is how long can we run these devices for? To do that, we simply multiply the wattage used by that device times the number of hours we see ourselves using that per day or per charging cycle for the Anker PowerHouse. Let's take our window-mounted AC unit as an example. Say it pulls 500 watts when it's keeping you cool. We multiply that by how many hours we want to use that to stay cool, and we'll know how many watt hours we need that day to meet those goals. Say we want to run it for 4 hours. 500 watts times 4 hours is 2,000 watt hours. Well, we're in luck because the capacity of the battery inside the Anker PowerHouse 767 is 2,000 watt hours. So we know that this unit has enough power to keep us cool with our window AC unit for 4 hours. If we want to stay cool for longer, say 8 hours, we'll know that we need to buy the expansion battery because that gets us another 2,000 watt hours, upping our runtime for the AC to our goal of 8 hours. Now, that's a lot of power, and everyone knows that air conditioning takes a lot of power, but we're in luck because it's the summer, the days are long, and hopefully our solar panels are able to keep our batteries charged. Let's talk about winter now. Say we're using our diesel heater, and let's say it uses 50 watts. That's 1/10 of the power, but we need to run it 24 hours a day if we want to stay comfortable. So we'll take 24 times 50, and that gets us 1,200 watt hours. We know that the PowerHouse holds 2,000 watt hours of power, so we can get 24 hours of use out of our diesel heater, no problem, even without the expansion battery. Despite the fact that the days are short and we're not gonna be making as much power as usual, we know we'll be able to stay warm. There's a lot that goes into making sure you can stay cool and comfortable or warm and toasty, but if you have the knowledge of your wattage, your amps, your watt hours, I'm sure you can find a solution that'll play nice with your Anker PowerHouse 767 so you can live in comfort anywhere, anytime, off the grid.